In this video, I'm going to give you a couple examples in terms of how do you solve a first order differential equation. The general form of the first order differential equation is shown in equation 1 here. And before you start solving it, you need to change it into the standard form in equation 2 here. The way you do is make sure that the coefficient in front of y is always equal to 1. So we can divide equation 1 by the constant b throughout the entire equation, and then you will get equation number 2. Through the process of the division, we have a coefficient in front of the dy dx, which we call it tau. We call tau the time constant. So something you need to remember, the differential equation must be in the standard form first before you start solving it. Here's an example of a differential equation. First order, sorry. Like I said, the first thing I'm going to do is make sure it's in the standard form. The way we do that is make sure we divide the equation by the coefficient in front of the y term. Make sure that number in front of y is equal to 1. Here's my tau. And this is something that you should know already. Either you look up on the table or from your other differential equation books. We know that the differential equation consists of two parts of the solution, the homogeneous and the particular solutions. For a first order differential equation, like I said, either from a table in your book or something from your prior differential equation books, you can look up that the homogeneous for standard first order differential equation is equal to constant A multiplied by E minus T over tau. So in this particular case, since I know tau is equal to 3, from looking at the number in front of the y dot term, I can tell right away that for this particular differential equation, my homogeneous equation is over 3. And now we're ready to look for the particular solution. We guess the particular solution to be of a similar form to the forcing function. In this case, the forcing function is a constant, so I'm going to guess my particular solution is a constant. And the derivative of a constant is equal to 0. I then plug back into the ODE. I'm going to get 3 times 0 plus b is equal to 5. So we have b equal to 5. As a result, I know the a e minus t over 3 plus 5. We will then plug into the initial condition to solve for the constant a. So let's go ahead and write plug in y sub 0 a times e to the 0 plus 5 equal to negative 2. So my solution One more example. Same differential equation. A different right hand side, cosine. Same thing, standardized form. Tau is equal to 3. My homogeneous solution. Guess a particular solution that's self-similar. So my particular solution, since this is a cosine function, anytime you have a sinusoidal function, either sine or cosine, both of these parts must be there at the same time. So I'm now going to start taking the derivative and plug it back into my original differential equation. Y dot p minus 5b sine. c cosine. Plug back into the original differential equation. I now have 3 minus 5b sine 5t plus b cosine sine. All of this must equal to 3 over 2 cosine 5t. Let's go ahead and collect the cosine terms. We're going to have 15c plus b equal to 3 over 2. Let's go ahead and collect the sine terms. We have minus 15b plus c equal to 0 because this is a 0 sign. Two equations, two unknowns, you can go ahead and solve for. And after you go ahead and solve for b and c, let t equal to 0 your initial condition is equal to the homogeneous solution plus a particular solution equal to 0 equal to negative 2, you can then solve for a. So, again, we can say that my solution is going to equal to A. Okay? You can go ahead and solve for the constant. One more example. Now, what happens when you have let's get back to standard form, or actually the original differential equation. A constant what happened? You have this. Same thing. standardize form, tau is equal to 3. So my homogeneous solution is A exponential function minus t over tau, or but what about my particular solution? There is something that's called the principle of the superposition. Requirement: the ODE must be linear. We do have a linear differential equation. The solutions can be summed. We actually did that when we say my solution is equal to the homogeneous solution plus the particular solution, right? So in this case, how many particular solutions do I have? The first one? The first one is solved in example 1. The second one is solved in example 2. If you go back to the prior slide, if you're taking notes following this video, you can then see then this is equal to my homogeneous particular solution for the constant is simply a constant. The particular solution for, so this is my first one, the second one is going to equal to a different constant C cosine 5t plus a constant D sine. And then you can plug in to solve A, B, C, and D. Another reason I'm not solving for these constants is that later on when we learn how to solve these differential equations using Laplace transform, you'll see that these constants A, B, C, D can be much more easily obtained when we do the transform math. Okay?